All right, so I know this may not be your thing here, but I want to start things off this way for about 30 seconds. So hear me out, all right? That was Timbaland, The Way I Are, with 2.6 million views, official music video. Good stuff. Or at least, I used to really dig the song back like 15 years ago. Like, it was good. Now, I have been thinking about something for years. But I was always wondering how I could get this to work and whether or not it's even a smart idea in the first place. So, I'm going to still talk with a friend of mine and see what we can come up with and all that. So, in short, the focus would be on intimacy and what that would look like with inside of the relationship. Obviously, take into context like all of the parts of it, the non-physical and the physical. As you very well know, touching is something that is... healthy touching is something that is not really happening to a lot of people. This isn't just simply affecting men or women. I hear many complain left and right about certain things, and it comes down to simply either being alone, not being touched enough, hugs, handshakes, arms on shoulders, that sort of thing. Doesn't have to be sexual. So, I'm wondering if whether or not there's any way to show to kind of do a 10 to 30 minute short video of what that would look like with nudity. Not exactly NSFW, but think of it more as non-graphic versus graphic. And what that would look like, biblically speaking. Because intimacy is something that, you know, you've got the Song of Solomon's, you've got the words. Now, in health, the phys ed classes, those classes that talk about what that looks like with, like, reproduction, you got pictures. And I'm wondering if there's a way to actually show intimacy in a way that's respectful and not just simply erotic, as in, we're here for your money and we're here to get you hooked. And this is important to me because of some of the things that I've seen, some that makes no sense. I can't just simply go into it. There's not enough time here. And on top of that, I'm probably going to go off too many different side trails and all that. Short and simple, I saw something years ago that made me wonder if this was even possible. This would probably take me down quite a few steps that I wonder if it would be even smart to begin with. Getting into the adult industry is one of them. Of course, if I'm going to get into it, that's not necessarily a problem because I know where I stand. I know what I'd be doing. But considering there's a lot of issues tied with that, a lot of abuse too, that is something that could cause... so many issues later down the road, it's not even funny. I think this video, this whole idea is worth thinking about, if nothing else. Obviously, raising money to get two actors, and I will go a little bit into this and how what I am seeing here. Two actors getting on a friendly basis, describing what I have in mind. And getting to know the other two people in the comfort zones, the do's, the do-nots, the off-limits, all that stuff. Probably even including safe words, because this matters. Safety matters more than anything else. You cannot have safety. Sorry, You cannot have intimacy without safety, without trust, without knowing that everything's going to be fine. Now, this is to simulate a relationship between a husband and wife. Now, biblically speaking, there's a lot that says, you know, a lot of do's, a lot of don'ts. But intimacy, what exactly does that look like? And too many other people are afraid to touch this subject because, oh, this is the wrong time, the wrong place. I don't feel comfortable talking about this. I know, I was there. I got a lot of these same responses that you probably got too when you asked. It's not just simply like, this isn't something like, oh, what's your favorite sex position? No, it's nothing like that. But I know it would probably include that at some point in the future. I do plan on asking some others around, trying to get their idea on what intimacy looks like. Because I don't know. I have my idea on what I think it is. I think I understand bits and pieces of it, but do I see it? Not in front of me. Do I live it? No. It's not really a part of my life. I mean, there's other friendships that I have with guys as far as sitting down and being open and honest, transparent about this stuff. My gym trainer being one of them. Which, by the way, I still have to buy that tripod just so I could... this is a bit off topic here, but in order to present that conversation perfectly, I need to get a tripod. I need to align the perfect shots, put in a mosaic piece of art that just kind of like rotates from like start to finish, just repeats over and over throughout the whole conversation since it's audio only. And I am a bit of a photographer. I have skills with that. I know. I need to like do like a golden hour thing that I got on my phone like back in 2022 or whatever. And it just showed like the best pictures of the year. Yes. I am a photographer. I do have my Facebook page, but currently it needs more pictures. I need to be on it every single day, posting up pictures that I've taken. Back to the main point here. It is a little awkward at first talking about it because, you know, talking about Pornhub is like, eh, want a Christian channel? Please. You're not a real Christian. Yeah, I am, and intimacy is the goal. Channeling the right things, avoiding that what does not help out with this is also part of the goal. Because it's probably very easy to go from intimacy to erotic where you're trying to turn people on. And obviously since I'm raising money, I don't exactly have like, I don't know, $5,000 sitting around where I could just invest and make this thing work. And on top of that, I could turn this into a brand and make it into something wholesome. Wholesome and, I don't know. I'm not exactly thinking big here. I just have an image in my mind and I'm wondering how far it can go and whether or not it's even a smart idea in the first place. But that being said, Pornhub is one of the probably better places. I mean, Xvideo, Pornhub, there's only two that come to mind. There may be other ones out there. But the idea is, on a platform where all this stuff is the norm, would be coming along something along the lines of like biblical intimacy, attached NSFW or whatever you would need attached to it in order to get people invested. Obviously, that's kind of like the goal there, but if we have to raise the money, we're going to have to like invest a little money into doing like a 30-second ad or whatever and try to raise awareness, get people to donate and say, hey, this is what I'm doing. I am linking this to my channel here. I hope you like it. Other good stuff is coming along the way. Because you know what? I don't talk much about sexual content. I do not talk much about that, which I've been wondering as far as how far that could go. Just because YouTube censorship and they're very sensitive about certain things. I've never been disrespectful towards men or women. And I can see how this would be pushing the buttons, crossing the line, or getting up to the line with some of the rules and all that. I don't know. but I'm sure as anything, not trying to cause issues, problems, drama, etc., etc. It's a really interesting idea that is going on a different platform. So the video wouldn't be coming over here anyway, on YouTube, since that's where I'm primarily at. I've been thinking about branching off to Rumble and a couple other places for a long time now, because I could make this whole brand grow in his mind. I could turn into something unique, something different. And yes, representing what is in one's mind can be very tricky, if not dangerous, just because people can go from being everything in a couple of seconds. Angry, happy, horny, sad, depressed, you name it, it's out there. People have gone through this stuff in like a range of like 5 seconds or less. You see all the emotions on one person's face. And anyway, I know they got memes and stuff out there. But anyway, point in case, like that song, The Way I Are, intimacy matters. We're lacking that in our lives as well, but it's not something that we need. What we need is to not be forgotten, to have a couple friends to talk to, people to socialize with, fellowship. We need that. The sexual stuff, which is big part of this idea here, is how would you do this appropriately in a biblical way? Obviously, it's like there would be a lot of touching. And yes, as I said, there would be nudity. But what kind, the positions, this stuff matters. And I've had things in my mind that I've been wondering about for a very long time. I don't know where some of these images came from, but they're tied to Dream, the character I've talked about before. And this stuff, like I said, I can't go into it because it makes absolutely no sense. And I have never made any headway into it for a very long time. I actually have a picture drawn of the female that is in my mind. She looks like a red demon, female demon, like a seductress of some kind. The person drew her all wrong, but hey, it's a start. Yeah. So from that angle, you could just simply do an easy an easy scene where this guy's being seduced and seducted by a female demon. So yes, a lot of touching, you can do it appropriately. You can do it in a way where it's not porn. Anyway, I'll be thinking about this a long time. This is just something that it popped up and I said, hey, I'll just talk about it for a little bit and mark it down as far as just mark it down and come back later. Do I expect anything to come from this? I don't know. I honestly don't know, but I'm doing a video here, so something tells me it is a very potential thing to happen. Like, it's a strong maybe. And on top of that, depending upon who would be involved, I may not need $5,000. $5,000 is literally just a starting place. All right, until next time. A lot to think about, I know. But hopefully you thought about what I said and think about what we've said. I would love to get some feedback, some of your thoughts on this. Good, bad, I'll take all criticisms. I already knew I'm opening a can of worms with this video to begin with. Dave, you crazy. I know. But I also see a very real need for a lot. A need for warnings. A need for reminders. A need for... this never been done before. I'm curious. It's not like I'm setting a standard here or anything, but when it comes down to intimacy, there's too little of it. Way too little. And I know some people are going to be, this is like the last point here. I know some people are going to be like, well, this is supposed to be intimate between a man and a husband and a wife. And I'm just like, Pornhub, X videos. You got these platforms where you got nudity. Yes, you're absolutely right. But in a sea of videos that is all about you you got something that's somewhat decent. And I already know I joked about it before with some others about, like, yeah, you can make $1 million on Pornhub, like, doing lessons, because people are checking stuff out and they're like, oh, what's this, educational video? The next thing you know, this guy's got like 1 million views. I have seen some of this stuff myself. I kid you not. I just can't believe it. Educational content on Pornhub? No way. Get out of here. That's kind of what I'm aiming for. Except, is this a really bad idea, or is this something that has potential? It's probably both, to be honest. Until next time. Thank you. Thank you for following me, and I hope you like the rest of the other videos I put down.